In this episode, we're using this Toyota Corolla L the right way. Here in Canada, it's available with a 6-speed manual transmission. So what better way to use it than to teach someone new to manual transmissions how to drive one of these? Yes, we're saving the manuals actively in this episode, and we've got a guinea pig, my son. Let's go for a drive. Before we get into the mechanicals of driving a manual transmission, the most important thing, the foundation, is how to sit properly. And there's not a lot of this on YouTube these days. Me coming from a racing background, this is fundamentally important to me. It's how you interface with the car, and what you don't want to be is stretched out like I see a lot of people on YouTube. That just says to me, nobody's ever done a performance driving school before. In this case, my child actually knows how to sit properly because unfortunately he's grown up around me and he's got to deal with this. As you can see, Devin is seated properly. We've done this in a little bit of a hurry. I mean, I could probably do a 2-hour episode on seating position, but what you want to see is that his shoulders are against the seat back, his elbows are bent, his wrists are bent, his knees are bent, his ankles are bent, so that he's got the greatest amount of control over this car. We'll save the lecture for another day, but if you're going to learn to drive a manual, definitely sit in this seating position. So Devin daily drives an automatic transmission. The reason for that is I thought it was particularly cruel of me to force him to drive a manual transmission in one of North America's very largest cities on a daily basis. I think that's just mean. However, his mother does drive a manual transmission, so that's another story for another day. Still, Devin, what do you think? Controls are a little bit different here, don't you think?
Yeah, there's definitely a lot more to keep track of.
So you've got 3 pedals instead of 2. And a different looking shifter.
Yeah.
So let's start with the basics, and that's how to start a manual transmission car. Okay. And especially in 2021, you've got to start them with a very specific sequence. This car actually has a key because it is the very most basic Corolla, kind of like your car, but doesn't have a start button. And all manual transmission cars today require you to have a foot on the brake and a foot on the clutch in order to start it. So let's do that. Foot on the brake, foot on the clutch, and start the car. Keep your feet there. Check this. So you know you're in neutral, mm-hmm. as far as the shifter goes, which means you can do what?
Move the shifter left and right.
Yeah, okay. And we're sitting here. We've got the parking brake on. Can you take your foot off the clutch or no?
Yeah, because the car's in neutral.
Yes. All right. We've taught him something already. So go ahead and do that. Take your foot off the clutch. All right, and because we've got the parking brake on, you can take your foot off the brake as well. So it's really that simple to start a manual transmission car, although I'm sure I've had manual transmissions that didn't require your foot on the brake or the clutch, but those are now vintage. These modern ones, for safety, require that you have your foot on the brake and on the clutch, so don't forget that. So the first step to get going with a manual is teaching this new driver how to find the bite point of the clutch, where it actually engages. And we're not going to get into the mechanical details of how a clutch works and all of that stuff, because that's going to be lost on Devin because he's not mechanically inclined. So what I'm going to teach him is how to find the bite point of the clutch. And all we're going to do is, with the car sitting here on level ground, lots of open space, lots of safety considerations here as well, I'm going to show Devin how to find that bite point of the clutch and get the car moving. We're going to do this a few times and move on to the next step. So how we do this is by putting your foot on the brake, foot on the clutch, take the parking brake off, first gear, foot off the brake, and all you're going to do is slowly release the clutch. That's all you're concentrating on.
Is that the bite point?
Yep, and we stalled it. So, let's try it again. Start the car. All you're concentrating on is releasing the clutch slowly, finding that point in which the car starts to move.
We are.
And then once we're going, you can actually take your foot off the clutch.
Oh, okay.
Neat, huh?
That's cool.
All right. So now to stop, put your foot on the clutch first, all the way to the floor, and then brake as you normally would. Is that how you brake?
That is, a new car. I'm still getting used to braking, but.
All right. So let's try this again.
This is going to take me some time.
This is attempt number 3. And then now that we're rolling, you can take your foot right off the clutch.
Okay.
You want to try it one more time just to get a sense of it?
Oh, I think I need one more practice try.
Clutch in first.
So, okay.
And then use the brake to stop. What do you think?
This is going to be easy.
One thing about Devin is he has a tremendous amount of confidence when learning something new very early on. All right, so if you want to proceed, we can add some gas, just like you're driving normally. Neat, huh?
Okay, we're going.
Okay, so would you like to try a shift?
Sure.
Okay, so a little more speed, because we're going a little too slow for second gear. To shift, it's relatively easy. At the same time you put the clutch in, you take your foot off the gas, you change gear, let the clutch out, add some gas. So you can take as much time as you want.
Okay.
So clutch in, off the gas,
shift down to 2,
clutch out slowly, and add some gas. Look at this. You want to try for third?
Oh my gosh, all right.
Okay.
I guess I have to.
All right, let's do it.
Let me get some a bit more speed going, I guess.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm learning to drive again.
It's scary for me.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, clutch in, shift to third, slowly clutch out, and add some gas. And now we're in third gear. While the going part might seem easy at this point, it's not that simple. Plus, eventually, we've got to come to a stop. So how you stop is you do brake normally like you do in your car. However, you've got to put the clutch in. The reason is the car will stall as it comes very close to a stop if you've got the clutch engaged. So to stop, you start braking, then put the clutch in all the way to the floor and come to a stop like you normally would.
Cool.
Easy. So now we can't start in third gear, so we got to go back to first gear. That's second. Remember, see, it says 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, first is up there. Okay, same as before, nice and easy. So notice, here's a great example. We're on a little bit of a hill. Oh, and we stalled it on the hill. So that's a great opportunity to talk about how to start on a hill. This car has a little bit of a hill hold. It holds the brake for maybe about a second and then releases. So it forces you to get going rather quickly. But of course, there are a couple of ways that you can remedy this. One is by keeping your foot on the brake just until the point you start releasing the clutch and then feed in some throttle. Or you can cheat and actually hold up the parking brake, which I don't necessarily recommend unless you're, you know, very skilled behind the wheel. So in this case, I'm going to recommend Devin uses the hill holder, get started with that clutch release as soon as possible, and then start feeding in some throttle at the same time. So this is a great opportunity to start adding some throttle to the mix. Okay, so as you start releasing the clutch, yeah, there you go, add some gas, just a little bit. Nope. Let's do it again. You're going to come off the brake pedal, start releasing the clutch at the same time, and with your right foot, you're going to add a little bit of gas. You don't want to add a lot because it's going to rev the motor and then you're going to do a little bit of a burnout, which we don't need to do. This is not Fast and the Furious. So again, as you come off the clutch, release the brake, go to the gas pedal, add a little bit of gas. And remember, you got to release that clutch pedal slowly. Just as you start moving your left foot, that clutch pedal, yep, you want to move over to the gas pedal, mm-hmm, and then add some gas. Okay, there we go. Oh, this is going to be interesting. Well, we're moving. This is good. That was nice. All right, second gear. Shift. I love this. This is great. Do you have any questions?
I'm just trying to feel it out. I don't know if I have questions so much as I'm just trying to figure out the exact feeling of when I need to do each step.
Right, and that's the thing, because you have to practice this. You can't just learn it in an instant.
Yeah.
Right, but you know, as much as Devin doesn't like cars, he's actually a pretty decent driver. He won't admit it, but he's a pretty decent driver. So I'm confident he's going to be able to figure this out. We're back to a stop. Devin's working on clutch feel, finding that bite point, that engagement point, and now adding some throttle to the mix. Nice. I'd give that an A minus. All right, shift to second. All right, add a little gas. Oh, and watch out for those things, remember? Okay, and let's brake to a stop and do it again. So brake first, clutch in, come to a stop. Okay. So you got a good feel for where that engagement point is, where that bite point of the clutch is, right?
Well, I'm trying.
No, you get, I mean, to be fair, I will say that this clutch has a pretty benign feel to it. Devin's mother's car has a great clutch. You can feel exactly what's going on with that clutch. In this car, that bite point is not so obvious. And one of the reasons we're doing it out here and we're doing it in this way is because this clutch pedal doesn't have a tremendous amount of feel. So one way to augment that is to be out here and get the car moving. So a lot of people will suggest that you sit in a parking lot with the parking brake up and just try and feel the clutch. Well, this car doesn't have that kind of feel. So we'd just be messing around trying to complete that exercise. So what I'm trying to do out here in the countryside is to use motion to augment any feel that's coming from the clutch pedal, because that's a great way to get your senses engaged and understand that the car is actually moving. So it's not entirely Devin's fault that he's stalling it all the time. This clutch doesn't have a great amount of feel. So let's try this one more time. Super easy to stall it though, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. It's shocking.
Okay, so in this, with this one, let's add a little gas to the mix. So the car's not gonna roll. So slowly let the clutch out, add a little gas as the clutch is coming out. Nice, look at that. That's pro level. Whew. Okay, sweet. Shift to second, quick, let's go, shift to second. A little faster than that. There we go. So the shifting part's not so difficult, is it? It's just the starting.
Yeah,
part.
Starting I find is like shifting, because the car's already in motion. I think, at least for my guesses, I think it gives you a little bit more freedom to not stall it.
We're going to do another start, and we're going to try and put everything together here with adding some throttle to the mix when we're starting. So, Dev, I think we're ready to go. We're on the flat here, so the car's really not going to roll away. Again, there we go. Look at that. I don't even have to tell him how to do it anymore. He's got it. There we go. Okay, my job's done.
I don't know about that. Uh-oh.
Oh, that's neutral. That's second. I think the Corolla is very forgiving, and it's because the way they've designed the clutch, you don't get a lot of feel out of it, but it's also very forgiving when you shift. So I think it's a little bit of a trade-off, and it's not so bad because it does make for a smoother ride and smoother shifting. When you're learning to drive a manual, one of the things that's going to give you anxiety is stalling the car in traffic. So what you need to practice is how to recover from a stall. Thankfully, this particular Corolla allows you to simply restart from the on position. You don't have to turn the ignition off and then back on. If you've got a start button car, it'll be the same process, except you're pressing the start button. Some cars, like I've driven some 911s, for example, that do have an anti-stall function. That's because they've got a start-stop function built into them. Not many manual cars do, but more and more cars with manual transmission do these days. But a few years ago, it was unheard of. So regardless, chances are you're not going to be driving something with an anti-stall function, so you're going to have to learn how to recover from a stall. So here we are. This particular Corolla allows you to do it very easily. So, Dev, let's give it a try. Chances are you're going to stall the start anyway.
True.
Because, I mean, how many have we done? Maybe a dozen?
Yeah, like 75% I've stalled the car.
Right. So So let's give it a go. Okay. And, well, I think you deliberately stalled it.
Well,
so,
yeah, I thought that was the point.
So to recover from a stall, what do you got to do?
Foot down on the clutch, foot down on the brake, and then just start the car.
Right. Now, in traffic, especially in our city, people behind you honking, get out of the way, loser. Give you the middle finger, right?
Yeah.
And then how are you going to feel?
Bad. I don't know. Is it supposed to make me feel good?
No. No, but forget the other people. So you can't let other people bother you when that happens. It's inevitable, so don't sweat it. And if they hit you, it's their fault anyway. So let's give this another try. And if you stall it, I want you to restart the car and get it going as quickly as possible. So okay. Now you understand how it all functions. So you, all you need to know is put your foot on the clutch, put your foot on the brake, get the thing going, let the clutch out, add some gas, right?
Let's do this.
Okay, let's do it. Okay, and let's go properly. Not a bad recovery.
Okay.
You want to try one more time?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
So the stall recovery is going to be very, very important. Don't overlook this. All right. So the one thing we haven't talked about is how do you back up in a manual transmission car?
That's a good question.
So in this case, what you need to know is how the shifter works for engaging reverse. And a lot of shifters work a little differently. This one has a collar. So if you can see, I have to pull the collar up in order for it to go into reverse. That's the only way. So what happens, so think about this. So what happens is without that collar pulled, you can't go over to reverse, so you can't screw up the gears. So when you're driving normally, obviously don't pull the collar up. And when you're driving normally, you're only limited to the 6 forward gears. But when you do this, you can actually engage reverse. So and before we do that, what you need to know is, what everybody needs to know, is reverse is actually a much shorter gear than first gear. So what that means is it actually accelerates the car a little quicker. So you have to be even more careful engaging reverse. By being careful, what I mean is you have to be careful with the clutch release.
Okay.
Okay. Now, look what happened. We've got the backup.
So it knows we're in reverse. Okay.
Yeah, car knows we're in reverse. And then the same thing to stop the car. Clutch in and brake to a stop. So you see, it was actually a little easier to get the car going in reverse because of that shorter gear. It's shorter for a bunch of reasons. Obviously, you're not going fast in reverse. If you are, then you've got real problems. But it also makes the car easier to move because of that shorter reverse gear than first gear. You're probably going to stall less in reverse than you are in first, simply because it's a shorter gear. So let's review what's just happened here. First and most importantly, I've got Devin seated in the right seating position. He's not stretched out. He's seated properly, so he's got great control over the car. He can reach the clutch completely. He can brake easily, all of that stuff. That is so, so important. From there, what did we do?
So the first thing we practiced was, oh my gosh, getting the car to start in first. And that was just like learning about like the slow progression of lifting your foot off the clutch so that you're able to smoothly get the car going, so that once the car is going, you can take your foot off the clutch without stalling it. And then we started practicing applying gas when you're shifting gears and pressing the clutch the whole way down, and then adding some throttle so that you can shift the gears smoothly. Then we started practicing that from the stopping position going into first. And then we practiced recovering from when you stall. And then after that, we did what we just did, which was practicing going into reverse.
Yeah! So don't forget to add some gas. Nice. See, that's perfect. That's nice and smooth. Great throttle application, great release of the clutch. Right, it was spot on. Okay, shift. That's not so good. If you're not a fan of the channel, we've got some more advanced driver techniques on the channel, like how to heel and toe, which is maybe something I'm not going to teach Devin today. And there are some other techniques that we can't talk about in terms of driving a manual transmission. We'll save those for another day. The entire point of this episode was to introduce Devin, who's not really familiar to a manual transmission, and get him going so he can drive a manual transmission car. And I think we've achieved that. Not bad.
I'm just trying to go around this corner smoothly.
Nice. So that was Devin intuitively downshifting into first gear so that we could turn the car around. And without any instruction, he did it quite well. So I'm impressed. Before we go, any advice to new manual transmission drivers?
I think what you were talking about is probably the best piece of advice I can give is about just trying to get the feel for that that point when you're lifting up the clutch where you can feel the car start to move, and kind of like waiting until you feel that motion to like start releasing your foot, I think is like the big thing. Because like what I felt like I had to do was like, sometimes I kind of think of things in like a little bit of a video gamey way. So I felt like I had to just slowly lift my foot off the clutch and gradually the car would start moving. But what I didn't realize was there was a specific point that I'd want to hold my foot at and wait for the car to start going before I completely lift it off. And I think that's the big thing I would say to people is don't just like slowly lift your foot off, but lift your foot to the point where the car starts to move forward and then completely lift your foot off. Don't just do it in one motion. It's like one motion, you hold it, and then a second motion.
That's a great way to break it down, and I think you're spot on that way. So well done. He's smarter than he looks. Thanks for hanging out with us and having a look at Devin's adventures and learning to drive a manual transmission in the 2021 Toyota Corolla L. Again, it's a Canadian special. You guys can't get it. Your base Corolla in the States has a CVT, so you can't get this car. It's $21,000 here in Canada, which represents a tremendous value, and it's really well put together. It drives well. It's exactly what you'd expect for a base model Corolla, but it's very, very well put together, very well finished. I'm impressed with it, and for 21 grand, you kind of can't argue. Now, Devin, what do you think about learning to drive a manual?
I like it. One thing I've always liked in video games about manual transmission cars is how I feel like you get a lot more control, so I'm excited to practice driving an actual manual transmission car more so that hopefully I can appreciate that about these as well.
Now, do you think your mother will let you drive her car?
We'll see, but I think probably not.
I hope not. Anyway, thanks for hanging out with us. And as a special thanks, Devin is now a member of the Save the Manuals Club, so he's going to get one of these t-shirts, and so is one of you. So please leave a comment below with the hashtag Save the Manuals, and you got to be a subscriber as well. So if you're not a subscriber, sorry. So make sure you're subscribed. Leave the hashtag Save the Manuals. Thanks again for hanging out with us. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even entry-level manual transmission cars. So any questions?
None so far, no.
Okay, so I think I'm gonna make you drive home now.
Oh my, okay, that's, oh no. Are we gonna film that? Because
no, we're not gonna film that.
That'll be fun to watch.